Hello everyone and welcome back to Eve Market, your weekly look at the Amman market. I have nothing special to say, but so we're going straight away towards the market prices. I'm gonna start off with titanium, of course. Get my list of last week. See, let's start off here. Titanium has been moving around a bit and last week it went up and it still went up a little bit. It had its highest point here, somewhere around 477 was its highest. And it looked like it's going down again now in price. It's a little bit moving. I need to set my autopilot on my ship. There we go. It's moving down again. There's a point for today, at least below the 460, so that is moving lower. The most prices for titanium are for the sellers. We're sitting at, let's see, in Amar, where are we? Yeah, 476 or 67. Sorry, 67. That went up, and buy price is 4.61. They went a little bit up since last week. The price last week was 4.56, so went a little bit up. And yes, it's my order. I'm short again. The titanium went on the price a little bit up since last week. Not a hell of a lot. Two pretty big orders. Mine and this one and this next one. If these get fulfilled, it's gonna drop below the price since last week. So one of these getting fulfilled before the price drops again. Let's see what Ferrite is doing. Ferrite went up two for about 1.5 to 2 weeks and seems to now going down again, dropping in price. It went above the 1150. And now it seems to be dropping below it, below the 1150 again. So, you know, price had an uptrend and starting to go down. Sellers, 1150, 1151 for the sellers. On the buyers, 1141. Went a little bit up in price. Last week was 1135, so it has been moving a little bit on its price, not a hell of a lot. So most of them seem to be going a little bit up. Alright, next one, Maxelon. Not really much to see. It seems to be slowly going up. For the last, let's see, 4 or 5 days, it seems to be pretty stable on the price, pretty flat line, yeah. So it has been going up and getting flat out a bit. Prices for Maxelon, 39.10, that's not really a huge amount, 25,000 units. 39.33 on the sellers. On the buyers, we're sitting at 38.35. Basically, that went down since last week. Maxelon has dropped in price. Last week price was 38.99, so more like 39, so it's dropped pretty, more than half an isk in its buyer's price. They're pretty decent amount for orders, so it will stay for a while, this. So that definitely has dropped in price since last week. Next one is Isogen. Isogen had a huge spike. Yeah, it went almost up to 130, from 115 to 130. And after that, it straightly dropped down again to about 117, 118. That was a big spike in, let's see, Yeah, the last week, 1.5 weeks also. That's just like titanium ferrite went up a bit in the same time. So it's going back down again. Let's see at the prices. For decent amount of oxygen, 123.48. And on the buy price is sitting at 117.11. That went a lot down the buyer's price since last week. Because last week was sitting at this huge spike here. And now it's sitting back at a lower price. So last week price was 123.48. We're sitting now at 117.11. So that's a good drop on its price. While we're at it, I need this badly. I change my price quick. There we go. Alright, next one, Noxium. Let's see what Noxium is. Still going down. It keeps dropping, Noxium. It's apparently a lot on the market, a good mineral to mine. But if people keep mining it, the price will keep dropping. How long is this now going down? Let's go for half a year, character. Yeah. It's going on for about, say, 4 months now. That this price is dropping for Noxium. See at the prices on the sellers sitting at 658.86, and on the buyers there's not really a huge amount of orders up for this, 628.62. There's still a pretty good drop on his price. Last week price was 665.41. So it really has dropped pretty a lot in price. You can see that the chat that keeps dropping. I wonder how long this one is gonna keep dropping. But it keeps on going. Alright, next up is Cyanrid. Cyanrid is still staying just above 600. The 5-day has moved above the 20-day again, so the price is slowly going up, so it looks like it hits the bottom point in the Cyanrid price. You can see here a little bit clear. See, the 5-day was sitting just below the 20-day. It's now then just hitting it. Here it was for at least 1, 2, 3, 4, 5 days. It was sitting exactly at the 20-day line, and now the last 3 days. 2, 3 days, it went a little bit above the 20-day, so it's sitting on its edge from going up in price, but today's price already below the 20-day average again. So it's maybe moving up sign, or maybe not. The price, it's not really clear what it's gonna do. Prices for Zynoid, there's a lot on the market here. Wow. A hell of a lot. Price 616.76 for the Cyanrid. On the sellers, on the buyers, 585.03. Last week price was 598.26. So that has gone down the price again. The few risks has dropped. So it's a bit unclear what Cyanrid is now gonna do, because it's been pretty flat. But it looks like it's going up, but on the other hand, it also looks like it's going further down. But it's a bit unclear what's gonna happen. Magnesite still on the drop. This is already going on for a pretty long time. Also almost for 4 months on the drop. That's amazing. It's gonna be a point of people's gonna buy it a lot. So that's still going down on the price. Nothing much to say about it really. So let's see, there's also a hell of a lot of orders on Megasite on the market, yeah. I think people think, oh, the price keeps dropping, let's get the max out of it now. People have been waiting too long to get the price up, and they're seeing it continue to drop now for like 4 months, and they think, if I wait longer, I can get even less money out of my Megasite and start dropping it all on the market. That's what this looks like. And that's gonna drive the price down even more. So the price for Megasite, 1709, well, 710 and just make of it. For Zynrid, it sells at 2 million units here on the market. That's a lot. And for the buyers, we're sitting at 1570.02. That went a little bit up since last week. Last week price was 1567.32. So that went a little bit up in price. It's not a lot, but it moved a little bit. Let's look on the last mineral, morphite. It's only been used for tech 2. Yesterday has been sold a lot, but hasn't done really anything to the price. The 5-day seems to be just above 20-day. Well, the buy price is sitting at 7,500. It looks like Morphite has found at the moment a very stable point on the market. Prices, there's only 2 units. 7,797.55 on the sellers. On the buyers, we're seeing 7,222.30. Last week, 7,300.13. So it went down in price for Megasite. Morphite, sorry. Megasite we just had. So Morphite went a little bit down on price since last week. We're gonna look at some salvage. The usual salvage on the domain region is gonna be getting a lot. Armor plates have to be were stable for like 1.5 week on the 160,000. Today it suddenly has a huge drop below the 150,000. It doesn't really look like anything special. There's been a little bit of a larger sale here a few days ago, but today I don't see really anything that's indicating a price drop, unless someone sold a lot towards sellers. So let's look at the prices. 157,000 on the sellers. On the buyers, 146,100. That went a huge drop. Last week was sitting just above 160,000. So that has moved a lot on its price, a lot down. So someone probably dropped this whole stock on the market that is driving this price down. From the armor plates was, if you see, 7,000, 5,000. There's a big order here still, so it's not gonna drop too easily. Yeah. But so yeah, probably someone sold a lot, probably this mark here. But then again, I had seen the price drop here, and we don't see that. We see only today's drop. Yeah. Maybe someone sold a lot. Is that on the same spot around the price? Yeah. Probably someone sold a lot in one go today. So, alright, let's go for the next one. Burn Logic Circuits. That one is still going up in price. I think just above the 31,000 on its price, so it is moving. On the price, sellers 32,271.05. Just below the 3,200 units. On the buy, we're sitting at 31,168.66. And last week price, that's a pretty big increase. 31,000, last week price was 30,000.022.53. There's a pretty increase in burn logic price. That one is going up. But you can also see pretty clearly on the market as in moving up. Last week we're sitting at this one at 30k line, and now it seems to be moving up. Alright, next one is the fried interface circuits. This one has also not really found a stable spot. It's bumping around a bit. Went up early this week to 4,500. This was a large amount sold. Someone bought them probably straight off market. They pushed the price up. Straight away it went down again. Around to 3,800, it looks like. Between 700 and 800. Someone needed them badly and probably bought pretty expensive then. See also the spike that pushed it up for a moment and straight away recovered. So on the prices, decent amount. 4,300 on the sellers, and on the buyers we're sitting at 3,802.57. That went just a very little bit down. Last week price was sitting at 3,809.30. So that is not really a huge change to it. A quick drink. Next one, melted capacitor consoles. That has been bouncing a lot this week. It was very stable and it's just going everywhere. Lowest point below the 5,500 and the highest point just below the 7,500. It really doesn't know what to do. Seeing now just below the 6,500 looks like today. But wait, in a week time it went pretty much to its lowest point almost in this three months chart and to its highest point. That's a very interesting thing, because people are buying and selling a lot of melted capacitor consoles, but it's moving the price around a lot. Price for it, 7,000. Flat for the seller price, if you have at least a decent amount. On the buyers, we're sitting there at 6,000. Someone really need a bet, because the next one's sitting at 5,408. That's that's almost 600 is difference in it. Then why the hell you set up this high? If you can even go a few hundred lower, because this one is sitting at the 2 jumps range. It's really bad they want these melted capacitor consoles then. Last week price was sitting at 5,408, that's this one. That was the last week price. And this is the new one, the 6,000. So he really badly wants his melted capacitor consoles. Alright, trip power circuits. That seems going down a little bit. 5 and 20 today are both going down, so this price is going to drop. I don't think it's going to drop a lot. Because it seems to be has dropped here and been going up and now it's going down again. No, I don't think it's going to drop a lot. Market data prices. Sellers, 120,500. On the sellers and on the buyers, 118,271.05. That went down with 1,000 ISK. Almost 1,000, just not. But basically, it went 1,000 ISK down. Last week price 119,201 was the last week's. And now it's 118. If I type in the right price. Indeed, if I type in the right price. Not a million. So yeah, trip power is going down on its price. The dummy. I'm still gonna look at this. This is the last time this week. If you want me still to cover this, let me know in a comment and we'll cover it for another month. To see what the price is doing. Dummy price is pretty flat. It's sitting just below the 150 million. It even has a drop here today on this price. So people are still pretty good supplies on the Dominix. And the price is not going up at the moment. Prices for the dummy about 152 million on the seller's price and about 144 million on the buyers. Build price for the dummy is still 161.6 million isk. Is it build price? So it still needs to get another 10 million on it before it's made a profit. To do it, to build it again and sell it on the market. It's just now still not profitable. So yeah, that's unfortunately. I have the same issue also. I got also a ship that I'm not building currently. Because of the price, it's also on a battleship. And that is the Amar one. It's the Geddon itself. That one is also not profitable for me to build, is it? Yeah, still being sold here for 120 million. Well, the Geddon build price is 171 million. It's also a battleship I'm not building at the moment. It's the only battleship I have. But I'm not doing it because it's not profitable. So yeah, that was this week's look at the Amar market. As I said, if you want me to keep covering the dummy, let me know. I will cover it next for the next month again. I'll maybe wait for a month and look in again. So, I'm lazy. That was this week's look. Hope you like it. If you like the video, please press the like button. And I will see you all next week. Fly safe.